Hey, hi there, Capricorn. Welcome to your September 2020 monthly psychic tarot card reading. Crosswatcher energies are interchangeable, but only take those portions that resonate with you. This is a general reading. I'd like to thank you guys for supporting my channel. It keeps me able to provide you with these readings for free. And there is a free birth chart calculator link at the very bottom of the description box below, and it can help you out with these readings. And now for your first card. It's the general atmosphere. It's the background and the basis of the matter. Number 14 of the major arcana in the Rider-Waite deck, Temperance. This can represent a Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Jupiter. Sagittarius could be in your chart, or it could be someone else you're dealing with. Now, this has to do with, it's a fire energy card. Jupiter rules Temperance. Jupiter, the planet of expansion and our evolution. Now, this is combining two different elements and using patience and moderation to combine these elements together. This is a card of adjustments, modification. It's adapting, it's using self-control, and it's working in harmony with others. It's compromise instead of battle, and never going to one extreme or the other. It's having control over your own life, and what you have imagined will come to pass. This is alchemy, successful combinations being achieved, seeing both sides and sharing control. It's the ability to combine different elements in life, such as work and pleasure, love and sex, feelings and action, openness and confidence. Yet it advises a cautious attitude and be moderate and take the middle way. Your second card, and this is the energy that's crossing over your path. These are your subconscious influences. The Seven of Wands, Capricorn, fire energy. This is a card of standing your ground. This is the Lion Heart. It's Mars in Aries. It's defending what matters. It's having to handle some tasks, tests. It's success against opposition and reaching a new level. It's victory through courage and being on top and wanting to stay that way. This is competition in business or trade. It's courage in difficult situations and beating down all problems. It's the excitement of conflict. You are now ready to face challenges, and you will stand your ground and fight for what you believe in, and your determination will overcome all obstacles. The Temperance with the Seven of Wands, this is management. It's patience needed to blend together due to differences, and that's two sevens in a reading which represent news. And now your third card. This is how it affects you. These are the external influences that you're consciously aware of. Number 5 of the major arcana, the Hierophant. This can be a Taurus. Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Jupiter could be in your chart or someone else's. Now this has to do with a relationship. It can be the assistance from a wise and helpful person. They can be a teacher or a mentor. It's also following a conservative path. It's being ruled by the conventional. It has to do with a belief system. This is wisdom revealed. It's a relationship, a commitment, acting respectable. It's the importance of social approval. It's the need to conform to society. It can be an organized religion and doing what is socially expected. Conformity, tradition, following a conservative path. These can be moral convictions. It's conformity to social expectations, licenses, certificates. It's making a vow and receiving a blessing. It's love through helpful doctrine. This can be a visionary. This is a person who has deep intuition and faith. Could be experiencing a religious or spiritual urge. It's following the path to knowledge and education. It's wisdom beyond the personal. It's conventional wisdom, established beliefs and rituals. It could be possible new contracts with the money situation. It's the desire to perform good works. The temperance with the Hierophant is formality. It's the institution of marriage, the legal documents, the ritual, it's legal commitments. This can be a counselor. It's tempered wisdom, and it's being blessed with patience. Your fourth card, it's the position with of the future. It's the outcome, the results, the resolution. The Knight of Wands, Capricorn, fire energy. This could be a Aries, a Leo, or a Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Jupiter. This is one of the fastest moving nights in the reading. They're impatient, hasty. This can also mean an adventure, a change of residence, a journey, a message. The movement is quick here. Could be travel to fun places. This person's might have a little trouble managing their money. But they can also be a generous friend or lover. But they're hasty in all they do. They're full of eagerness and self-confidence, yet they don't always know where they're going. And without those concrete plans, they can burn out before they achieve their goals. This is a kickstart. It spurs you on. It's someone that's raring to go. They're always on a passionate mission, in and out of the scene. They're poised for action, pursuit. This could be good news concerning your work or social activities. Could even be an anticipated happy event, a journey or a vacation, change of residence or a job. Could even be an engagement or a marriage. Knights are driven by passion for a cause. Well, passion is the cause for the Knight of the Wands. If it hastens the pulse, or spikes the adrenaline, or raises the stakes, this knight charges after it. They're impatient with details, and they're inclined to attract attention, but they're eager to show what they're made of. And if there's applause for their efforts, they'll happily repeat the performance. This is a strong start, but it might not last if you get lazy. This starts out enthusiastic, but it can fade out. There's a lesson here that before this person can reach maturity, they must temper their appetites with restraint. Such discipline is what separates the journeyman from the masters. The Temperance card with the Knight of Wands are trials, challenges. Its opposites attract and make steam. It's patience and action. It's combining the need for action with patience. Your fifth card, it's the bottom of the deck card. The underlying issue. This is what's unseen. It's unseen, it's because it's something that you're not sharing with others, yet you are consciously aware of this. Number 15 of the Major Arcana, the Devil. Here you are, Capricorn, this represents you. This is an earth energy. Now this is a temptation which brings in bondage and limitations. It could be chained by wrong choices or chained by greed. This is extra energy. It's toxic energy. It could be dark. Brings in discontent, depression, sometimes illness. This is a bondage to material. It's having to face up to your demons. It's a challenge of repression and of illusions. This can be an oppressive situation. It can be controlling. Brings in illusions of helplessness. This can also indicate a sexual relationship that has become obsessive or destructive. It can refer to a person with power over another or overdoing something too much. It's tempting. You really like it, so it keeps you from accomplishing other things. This can be a pleasure-seeking couple. There may be restrictions and fear, lust, addictions, anger, emotional games. Maybe it's being ashamed or jealous or codependent. Self-destructive, shackled by ignorance, or chained to the need for approval, or feeling the need to control others. This is serving what enslaves you. You'll need to place boundaries against users and takers. You could be experiencing restrictions or acting in ways that impede your growth, struggling with or denying addictions or depression, projecting faults onto others or having them projected onto you. You may need to accept the restrictions of the current situation. This can be a negative relationship with deep denial. This is the trickster. It can be detrimental. This could be a person that's full of empty or false promises, and they never take the blame. They always blame the victim. Temperance with a devil card is falling off the wagon, or vice versa. It's abstaining from addiction. It's an awareness of routine. It can be a new situation that ceases to be new. It's the stabilization of a change in the life cycle. The Seven of Wands with the Hermit card is holding your boundaries. It's confidence in your knowledge. This can represent someone that's born to teach. It's self-confidence defending your inner knowledge. The Seven of Wands with the Knight of Wands represents contradictions, making decisions and wanting them to be respected. It's having the last word in an argument. It's saying one thing and then doing another. The Seven of Wands with the Devil card is stubborn aggression. It can be fighting a battle for a manipulative, controlling person. Or you might need to slow down and make sure you're not being used. It could be fighting a battle for control. The Hierophant with the Knight of Wands is someone on a mission. It can be spiritual work. They can be a spiritual warrior. The Hierophant with the Devil card. These are exact opposites. The tension will be whether chaos or order reigns supreme in your life. It's learning through experiences. It's not following moral codes. This can also be body training and marksmanship. The Knight of Wands with the Devil card can represent a bad accident. Beware. This can be a bully, or they could be more interested in a sexual adventure. This is following desires and can represent a pushy person. Your Vice Versa Tarot card by the Lunaea Weatherstone. You have number 16 of the major arcana, the Tower. The Tower's fire energy. Could be an Aries or a Scorpio. Now, we'll give you the definition in the Vice Versa deck book. It's from this side. Out of nowhere, a sudden bolt of lightning strikes a tower and blasts its two occupants from its shelter. The king and his architect constructed and possessed the tower, which in their conceit they thought to be indestructible. But their earthly roles are meaningless to the eye of God. Whatever illusion they had about their power and permanence is burned away as they fall toward the waters below. The presence of a dove, the Holy Spirit, assures them that they have not been abandoned, and they are in no way in any condition to believe it at the moment. When you get this side in a reading, there is no way to prepare for the tower's experience other than to know it's coming. Look for the weaknesses in your foundation. Where are you complacent? Where are you vulnerable? Do you have the inner and outer resources you need to deal with a big change? It's good to be alarmed when you get the Tower card. It's both a wake-up call and a cautionary tale. Don't sugarcoat the message. The time for denial is long past. Thanks, you guys, Capricorn. I hope you stay tuned in and leave me a comment or a thumbs up. And please subscribe. Now remember, what goes around comes around, so I'm sending you out love and light and blessings. Thanks for watching.